Now, whether it's a parcel off a doorstep or a toy bunny left in an airport lounge, we all know the feeling of losing something special to us.
But what happens when it's your wedding ring, and how long would you hold out hope of getting it back? Our reporter Tirohiringa Brown tries to unravel a decades-old mystery.
It's a 45-year-old mystery that's been brought to the surface.
It had that shine on it like that when I found it.
It was 1976 when a young Harry Court stumbled upon a piece of hidden treasure.
When I stood on it and I moved back, I could see it wasn't a bottle top or a piece of glass or something. I bent over and picked it up, thinking it might have been a bit of a fishing tackle or something, but it wasn't. It turned out to be a ring.
A golden wedding ring.
With somebody's names inside it.
Engraved with the names Steve and Tina, along with the date they tied the knot.
It's unusual to find a full name like that. And a ring that size.
Found on the beautiful shores of Kawakawa Bay. Without the power of technology, Harry looked in the local newspaper every day, trying to track down Steve and Tina.
No mobile phones, there was no telephone, nothing. I didn't know where to take it, except the police station. What would they do with it? Keep it 3 months and ring me up and say, oh, no one's claimed it, you can have it back again. So that would be a waste of time, wouldn't it?
But after a while, he gave up.
How it got out there, I don't know. They got sick of it and threw it away in anger or something, I don't know. It would have a history, but don't tell on us.
And so the ring was put away in the trusty old shed.
So I stuck it up there, and then I just completely forgot all about it. Like I do everything else, and that's why there's so much stuff in there, because I keep forgetting about it. Until I want it, and then I can't find it.
Only to be rediscovered 40-odd years later. But now, there's social media. His daughter-in-law got Harry's find on the local grapevine.
What do I do with this? And I showed it. I don't know who it is, but it's got a name in it. So she said, oh, well, I'll put it on, I don't know, it's Facebook or one of them things to see if... And there it was. Hopefully we'll find who owns it and they can have it back again.
You see, Harry is determined to find the owner of the wedding ring because, well, he's lost a few of his own.
Not a good feeling, because you know you've got to go back and then you've got to face the missus and they say, I've lost my wedding ring. And she says, oh, not another one, you know. Well, I've lost this one a couple of times, three times, I think.
Maybe one day we'll have someone on 7 Sharp who found that ring, your ring.
But it hasn't got any names in it.
Oh, so. Okay. Yeah, well, that's why you need to get your ring.
I would know if it was mine, because it would fit.
Theories as to how the ring ended up in the water.
I would say possibly swimming. If that's anything like mine, because it just slips off.
Or maybe it was chucked there on purpose. What we do know is that the hunt is on.
I know the feeling. If to lose something and get it back again, it's really good. It's like if you relive the moment when you first got it again.
My prediction is that we are going to find Steve and Tina, and we're going to find the owners of that ring. This is our specialty.
It is. Sharp. Lost and found.
Yeah.
How many times have we done it? I've lost count, quite frankly.
I know, dozens.
Steve and Tina, were you married in 1973? For the happy ending, I want Steve and Tina to be still together.
Someone's going to know Steve and Tina, aren't
please.
1973.
Please. We want to reunite you with your golden ring. Make contact. All the platforms. We're here waiting for your call.